Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a big challenge. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Seraph, a travel by vintage steamer. Chapter 1. The Gentle Giants of the River. The morning had broken over the grand old river, its banks cloaked in a mist that rose like spirits from the waters. The steamship, a majestic relic from a different age, lay moored to the wooden dock, its body still inexpected. It was a vessel that harkened back to the golden age of river travel, its twin smokestacks reaching towards the awakening sky like the pillars of some ancient temple. The passengers, a microcosm of society's finest, trickled aboard with a sense of unhurried anticipation, their garments a testament to the sartorial elegance of the era. Ladies in flowing gowns and feathered hats, their fabrics rustling whispers of silk and taffeta, accompanied gentlemen whose tailored suits and polished shoes spoke of quiet affluence. The air was thick with the scent of burning coal and freshly varnished wood, a perfume that bespoke the union of nature and industry. The steamship, named the Seraph, bore the patina of countless voyages, her deck scrubbed to a welcoming sheen, her brass fixtures winking in the burgeoning light. As the last of the cargo was loaded, a blend of the practical and the luxurious, the crew made ready to depart. The captain, a seasoned mariner with a beard as white as the foam that would soon trail behind them, oversaw the preparations with a practiced eye. His command was the helm of this floating world, and he was as much a part of the ship as the keel that sliced through the water. Aboard the Seraph, the passengers found themselves stepping into a realm that defied time's relentless march. The cabins were adorned with the finest mahogany and brass, the beds dressed in linens that whispered of soft indulgences. Every detail was a tribute to the craft and care of an era that took pride in the art of travel. As the hour of departure neared, a hush fell upon the assemblage. The thrum of the engines grew to a steady purr, a mechanical heartbeat that promised the adventures that lay ahead. With a lurch that sent ripples dancing across the surface of the river, the Seraph began her stately dance downstream. The shores of the river were a shifting canvas of verdant hues, the trees in their summer finery nodding their leafy crowns as the steamship passed. Herons and egrets took flight from the reeds, their wings etching patterns against the blue expanse overhead. The river itself, a serpent of liquid glass, reflected the world in perfect symmetry, only to have its artwork undone by the passage of the boat's great paddle wheels. The passengers, now settled into the rhythm of the voyage, began to explore the many splendors of the Seraph. The saloon was a grand chamber of carved panels and beveled mirrors, where one could partake of a morning libation or engage in hushed conversations that were as much about being seen as they were about speaking. Children, the embodiment of untamed curiosity, darted about with laughter that echoed off the polished surfaces. They peered over the railings, eyes wide with wonder at the great expanse of water that stretched to the horizon. Their imaginations were unbound, each bend in the river a new chapter in an unwritten epic. The dining room awaited the travelers, a sumptuous spread that brought the bounty of both land and river to the table. The clatter of cutlery and the murmur of voices became the soundtrack to a scene that was as much about the ceremony of dining as it was about the food itself. As the Seraph continued her journey, the passengers felt themselves slipping into a state of tranquil detachment. The concerns and clamor of the docks were now a world away, replaced by the serene certainty of the river's course. It was a tranquility that was not merely felt, but worn like a garment, a cloak of contentment that draped over the shoulders and settled deep in the soul. The river, with its languid curves and gentle currents, was a guide and a companion. It whispered tales of the ages, of steamboats and sailors, of settlements that had grown from its banks like children from a nurturing parent. The journey was as much about the stories as it was about the distance traveled. The sun climbed higher, casting a golden glow upon the scene. The Seraph, with her cargo of lives and dreams, moved with a grace that belied her years, a testament to the time when travel was an art and the journey as important as the destination. As the day unfolded, new friendships were forged under the benevolent gaze of the sun. The riverboat, a vessel of wood and iron, of steam and steel, coursed through the heartland with the certainty of a bygone promise, a vessel not merely of travel but of time itself, carrying its passengers not just down the river, but through the very essence of an era that lived and breathed in every plank and rivet of her being. The river flowed on, indifferent to the passage of time, a silent witness to the lives that intersected upon its bosom. And the riverboat, a venerable vessel of wood and steam, listened to every word, a faithful chronicler of the human condition, as it steamed towards the amber horizon, ready to etch another page in the annals of its storied journey. Chapter 2. Echoes of Steam and Time. The Seraph, with the steady beat of her engines, became a world unto itself as it glided through the waterways. Her passengers, an eclectic assembly of souls drawn from the far corners of the globe, found themselves entranced by the shifting scenery that unspooled like a living tapestry along the river's edge. As the vessel steamed past quaint villages and bustling townships, the passengers observed the daily theater of life on the riverbanks. Fishermen cast their nets with the elegance of performers on a watery stage, while children splashed in the shallows, their peals of laughter carried over the water to mingle with the call of the birds. Amidst the socialites and adventurers, there was Miss Eleanor Gainsborough, a young writer with eyes as keen as her pen, who found inspiration in the gentle lapping of the waves against the hull. She sat on the upper deck, her notebook resting on her lap, capturing vignettes of life as they passed. Her prose wove the lives of the riverside dwellers with the travelers aboard the Seraph into a single, flowing narrative. Below deck, in the opulence of the lounge, gentlemen engaged in spirited discussions over brandy and cigars. The room was a cocoon of leather and mahogany, where the world's troubles were debated and, with a touch of whimsy, solved within the span of an evening. Mr. Archibald Forsyth, a man of industry, spoke with fervor about the marvels of the modern age, his voice rich with the thunder of progress. Evening drew near, and the steamship was awash with the golden hues of the setting sun. The passengers congregated on the deck to witness the spectacle of twilight upon the river. The sky, painted in strokes of crimson and lavender, reflected upon the water, setting it aflame with color. Dinner was a grand affair, the tables dressed in white linen and crystal. The clinking of glasses underscored the hum of conversation as courses were served with ceremonial precision. The fare was exquisite, a dance of flavors that paid homage to the regions through which they sailed. Each dish was a story, each sip of wine a verse, and a song of culinary delight. In the grand dining hall, the ship's own orchestra played, their music a soothing balm that smoothed the creases of even the weariest brow. The strings sang of distant lands, the brass of bold adventures, and the woodwinds of the sweet, melancholic joy that travel brings. After dinner, the grand saloon beckoned. The chandeliers cast a warm glow over the evening's entertainments. A pianist conjured melodies from ivory keys, while couples danced with a grace that mirrored the flow of the river outside. The air was perfumed with the scent of roses and the subtle hint of perfume, the room a tableau of genteel refinement. Madame Isabelle Dupont, a lady of Parisian high society, captivated a circle of admirers with tales of the capitals of Europe. Her laughter was like music, her stories a bridge between the old world and the new. She was an enchantress, and the saloon her court. As the night deepened, the Seraph slipped through the water like a phantom, her lights a beacon in the darkness. The stars emerged, a celestial audience to the river's nocturne, their reflections upon the water a scattered mosaic of silver and shadow, and the quiet of the night, with the majority of passengers retired to their quarters, a few solitary figures remained on deck. They stood by the rail, gazing out at the dark silhouette of the landscape, the only sound the hiss of steam and the distant call of nocturnal creatures. The river, a black ribbon beneath the moon's gaze, carried them through the quiet majesty of the night. The captain, ever vigilant, stood at the helm, his silhouette a steadfast monument against the tapestry of lights and shadows. The Seraph was more than a ship to him, she was a testament to the age of steam, a vessel that carried not just people, but the dreams and aspirations of an era that sought to shrink the world and expand horizons. In the engine room, the stokers worked in a symphony of exertion, feeding the hungry boilers that powered the great wheels. Their labor was the hidden heartbeat of the Seraph, a pulse that drove her through the night towards the dawn of a new day. The Seraph bore her passengers not just along the river, but across the threshold of time, enveloping them in an experience that transcended the mere passage from place to place. Each moment aboard was a stitch in the fabric of their lives, each experience a thread in the rich tapestry that would become a treasured memory of a time when the journey was as grand as the destination. As the first light of dawn crept over the horizon, a subtle change came over the riverboat. The Seraph, with the promise of morning, prepared to unveil a new chapter in her voyage, a fresh canvas upon which the day would paint its story. And as the light grew stronger, it promised the revelation of new landscapes, new faces, and new stories to enrich the souls of all who journeyed on this grand vessel of bygone days. Chapter 3. Echoes of the Steam Age. The dawn greeted the Seraph with a blush of pink and orange, painting the sky in the hues of an old master's canvas. As the first rays of sunlight kissed the surface of the river, the steamship seemed to awaken from its nocturnal reverie, stretching into the day like a cat in the warmth of the sun. On the third day of the voyage, the steamship approached a region where the river unfurled itself into a wider basin bordered by lush green hills that promised tales of old. The landscape was a living fresco of nature, with each bend of the river revealing a new secret, a new beauty to behold. Breakfast was served on the upper deck, allowing passengers to dine amidst the splendor of the morning. The tables were arranged so everyone could have an unobstructed view of the riverbanks as they drifted by. The air was filled with the aroma of fresh coffee and warm pastries, a symphony of scents that harmonized with the fresh morning air. Among the early risers was Professor Jameson, an antiquarian whose passion for history was matched only by his love for the steam age. With his spectacles perched on his nose and a book always at hand, he regaled his fellow passengers with stories of the river's past, of empires that rose and fell upon its banks, and of the steamboats that had once been the queens of the river. The children aboard found their own adventures on the lower decks, their imaginations kindled by the ship's majesty. They played games of pirates and explorers, their laughter and shouts a counterpoint to the steady thrum of the engines. Their parents watched on with a fondness, knowing that these memories would be etched into their children's hearts for a lifetime. As the morning unfolded, the Seraph passed by ancient ruins that spoke of a time long gone. Crumbled walls and remnants of towers stood as silent sentinels on the hillsides, their stones holding the warmth of the sun and the secrets of ages. The passengers, spellbound by the sight, listened as the professor explained the significance of these ruins, the lives that once thrived there, and the history that flowed as surely as the river beside them. The ship's library became a haven for those seeking tranquility. It was a room lined with books that smelled of leather and paper, a repository of knowledge that spanned the breadth of human thought and discovery. Here, the curious and the scholarly delved into volumes of poetry and history, their minds traveling even further than the steamship could carry them. By midday, the Seraph docked at a small town renowned for its market. Passengers disembarked to explore, to stretch their legs on solid ground, and to engage with the locals. The market was a kaleidoscope of colors and sounds, with stalls laden with the bounty of the region, fresh fruits, vibrant textiles, and handcrafted wares that bore the imprint of the artisan's hand. Miss Abigail Sinclair, a botanist, was particularly taken with the local flora. She wandered the market with a basket on her arm, selecting specimens with a discerning eye. Her conversation with the vendors, full of questions about cultivation and uses, bridged the gap between visitor and local, science and tradition. The return to the ship was heralded by the call of the steam whistle, a sound that echoed through the town and along the river. The Seraph, like a mother hen, gathered her brood back from their brief sojourn on land and prepared to continue the journey. In the afternoon, the steamship hosted a lecture by the professor in the Grand Saloon. It was an event that drew many of the passengers, eager to learn about the engineering marvels that made the steam age possible. The talk was illustrated with diagrams and models, bringing the mechanics of steam power to life in a way that was both educational and entertaining. As the lecture concluded, the passengers dispersed to various activities. Some returned to their cabins to rest, others to the lounge for a game of cards or chess, and a few to the ship's rail to simply watch the river and its ever-changing face. Tea time was an elegant affair, with the serving of delicate sandwiches and fine pastries. It was a time for socializing, for the sharing of experiences and the forming of friendships. Conversations flowed as smoothly as the river, encompassing topics as diverse as the passengers themselves. The evening brought another sumptuous dinner, followed by a recital in the saloon. A renowned violinist, traveling to a concert in Vienna, graced the passengers with a performance that was both intimate and sublime. The music, rich and evocative, filled the room and touched the souls of all who listened. Later, the night sky became an amphitheater to the wonders of the heavens. An astronomer among the passengers pointed out constellations and told the myths that wove around them, connecting the dots of light into stories that transcended time and place. As the passengers retired to their cabins, the gentle rocking of the Seraph cradled them into slumber. They slept with the knowledge that tomorrow would bring new wonders, new stories, and new memories to cherish. The river, a constant companion, whispered its lullabies as the steamship glided through the night, a timeless journey through the echoes of the steam age. Chapter 4. The Pulse of the River. The Seraph continued its grand voyage, gliding with the dignity of a swan over the calm waters. The sun was a shy performer on the fourth day, hiding behind a veil of silvery clouds that gave the world a soft, diffused light. It was as if the heavens had decided to grace the earth with a day of gentle repose, a brief respite for the weary and a canvas for the thoughtful. As the hours rolled on, the steamship passed by landscapes that seemed to be plucked from a dreamer's imagination. The riverbanks here were dotted with quaint cottages and small hamlets where time appeared to move at its own measured pace. Smoke curled from chimneys in lazy spirals, and the fragrance of burning wood carried across the water, mingling with the mist that rose from the river's surface. The passengers, now accustomed to the rhythms of the ship, found their own pace. Some gathered on the deck with sketchbooks and paints, attempting to capture the essence of the scenery with strokes of color and light. Among them was Mademoiselle Lefebvre, a Parisian artist whose eyes saw the world in shades of impressionistic wonder. Her canvas blossomed with the hues of the river, an ever-changing masterpiece that mirrored the journey itself. Beneath the deck, the engine room was a sanctuary of heat and motion. The engineers and stokers worked in a ballet of efficiency, their faces aglow with the fire of the furnaces. To the uninitiated, it was a place of noise and soot, but to those who understood its language, it was the beating heart of the Seraph, pumping life into its steel veins. Lunch was served in the grand dining hall, a room resplendent with polished wood and gleaming brass. The gentle clinking of cutlery and the murmur of conversation created a symphony of social harmony. The menu featured delicacies of the region, each course a testament to the culinary arts that flourished in the embrace of the river's bounty, and in the quiet of the ship's library. A group of enthusiasts gathered around a grand old map spread across a table. It was a map of the river and its environs, each twist and turn annotated with legends and landmarks. The map was not just a guide, it was a storyteller, unraveling the tapestry of the region's history. Here, the curious traced the paths of ancient armies, the trade routes of medieval merchants, and the journeys of explorers who had once sought the river's secrets. The afternoon saw the Seraph approaching a region where the river narrowed, its banks converging as if to whisper to the voyagers. The water here ran deeper, carrying with it the reflections of overhanging trees that dipped their leaves in homage. The sound of the steamship's horn reverberated through the corridors of nature, announcing its passage to the silent observers of the forest. On the upper deck, the more adventurous passengers assembled for a presentation by the ship's captain. With a voice that carried the timbre of the river's depth, he recounted tales of navigation and the challenges faced by steamships of yesteryear. His hands, withered as the wood he stood upon, gestured to the horizon, to the bends in the river that held stories of narrow escapes and moments of triumph. The children, their energy seemingly inexhaustible, were entertained by the ship's crew with games and stories. A treasure hunt had been organized, with clues hidden in nooks and crannies of the ship, leading to a mock treasure chest filled with sweets and trinkets. Their joyous cries and eager searches added a layer of youthful vigor to the vessel's stately progress. As evening approached, the ship's musicians assembled on the deck, their instruments gleaming in the fading light. A concert of classical pieces commenced, the melodies soaring above the river, reaching out to the shores where villagers paused in their chores to listen to the music carried on the breeze. Dinner was a grand affair, the tables adorned with candles that flickered like stars brought down to earth. The passengers, dressed in their evening finery, partook in a feast that celebrated not just the food, but the camaraderie that had blossomed among them. Toasts were made, stories shared, and laughter rang out, a joyous affirmation of the bonds formed in the shared embrace of the journey. Later, the passengers gathered on the deck, wrapped in blankets against the chill of the night. The stars were out in full attendance, a celestial show that outshone the most elaborate fireworks. The astronomer, now a familiar figure with his telescope and tails, guided the passengers across the heavens, connecting the dots of light into constellations that told the oldest stories known to humankind. As the night deepened, a sense of peace settled over the Seraph. Passengers retired to their cabins, lulled into slumber by the gentle rocking of the ship. In their dreams, they sailed through stars and time, each in their own imagined vessel, charting courses through the landscapes of their minds. The river, a constant companion, whispered its lullabies. The steamship, the Seraph, glided through the night, its course steady and sure, a timeless journey through the echoes of the steam age, carrying souls who sought the serenity of the past in the heart of the present. As dawn would break, new wonders awaited, new stories to be told, and new memories to be cherished. The journey was more than a passage through water. It was a voyage through the essence of life itself.